see far, far away, celebrities have world-famous chefs cook for them. So what do celebrities eat for breakfast, lunch and dinner? And do they have cheat days? Or are they on strict diets? Well, here to spill the beans is Chef to the Stars, Dave Little. First of all, what are you making for us today?
Alaskan king crab cocktail.
So, oh. Which was the favourite dish of?
George Lucas.
Of wow. Star Wars fame.
He loved it. He loved his seafood, crab, lobster, all that kind of stuff.
Well, wow. Let's get started.
Now, I've got the scissors. You don't realise what you've done giving me.
I do. I gave you that job on purpose. So, can you?
Yep.
Yep. I'll show you.
You did show me. You go down here. Yeah. Is that the softest part
and,
there?
Yep, you keep doing that. And do you just want to cut these up for me?
Sure. Oh. So slice and, them?
Bite-sized pieces.
And I've got the forks here because, as they say in Star Wars, may the forks be with you. That's
true. Are you a Star Wars fan, Dave?
I am a huge Star Wars fan. So when
you get the call, what do you do? Do you, you know, George Lucas wants you to cook for him, be his personal chef. That must be pretty cool.
It was very daunting. Went in for the job. I got it, which, to my amazement, and, that was fantastic.
What happens? I've always wondered, like, he's richer than God, right? So does he just, are you just there at his house all the time and he just calls you up at 3 o'clock in the morning and says, oh, I could really do it with an Alaskan crab cocktail right now?
Pretty much, yeah.
Really?
So on call.
Sorry, I've struck a snare. I've only got it to there. Do I just take it off there and then go back to next
Give that
bit?
To me and I'll... Sorry, Dave.
And do you want me to chop these things?
You're right. Just cut that up, the chives, please. Okay.
Oh, yum.
So,
can you see that?
Now, see, I'm not a seafood person, but I love this.
Look at that.
Oh, beautiful.
Look at that, crab.
Do you want me to go further, though?
Just do another one.
Can anyone hear that whispering in the background? Can you hear that whispering? That's just my chive talking.
That's terrible. That's enough of that. Do you want to cut that?
Sure. Again, like in little slices?
However you want. Yeah,
okay.
That's
fine. So what other foods does George Lucas like? Like, what are some of his favourites? Does he have cheat days? Because we saw him being... He was papped in a food court.
I did hear about
that. Yeah.
Which was pretty cool. Means he just likes food court grub
like he loved all that kind of stuff, like burgers and steaks and just lots of fish.
Yeah, right.
Can I ask
lots of lobster, as I said before, I think.
What do you do with that? You don't waste that, do you?
No, I'll make a stock out of that.
Ah, that's right.
Like a ravioli or something like that.
Ooh. Okay, just like to know what you do with the bits. Right? Yeah.
So when you were working for George Lucas, did you ever get sick of talking about George Lucas?
That's a very... Yeah, everyone asks me about George Lucas. They don't ask me about
food or anything else.
Yeah, yeah.
But you've got a restaurant? Or
I do. It's called Mr. G's in Double Bay.
That's right.
An American steakhouse. We do this crab cocktail. It's old style, New York.
I love that.
All that kind of stuff.
So what is it, Mr.?
Mr. G's.
There's always debate about steaks. You know, how do you cook them? Do you turn them just once, or do you turn them several times? Or can you settle it for us right now?
You just need a nice hot temperature and cook them nice and evenly, and you can't go wrong.
You can't go wrong. Does it matter how many times you turn them?
Doesn't it toughen it?
No, not really.
If you go like that.
No, it's all good.
You sure?
But at Mr. G's, what we do, we cook it over charcoal. Can you just cut that up for me, please?
That's the difference.
So charcoal.
In little slices.
Ooh, bend your fingers,
I used to be much really stronger.
Try this one.
So just little slices.
That's a great knife, that one.
Like this.
Perfect.
Like that.
Perfect. And you've got a sauce here. Is this just a Thousand Island dressing?
Pretty much.
Oh, wow. This one bit back.
So I think we can start assembling, I reckon.
Yeah, great. Oh, sorry, pardon me. It's all right, I've got 9 left.
Just that one. Sarah, could you just put that for me?
Take that bit off.
Shred it up however you like.
Yep.
And I'll start building.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, grab some of that.
Do you think we have what it takes to work in a commercial kitchen?
Not really.
I think you do.
Oh, that is sharp.
Don't encourage
yourself,
him.
Please.
It's a good knife.
What are those little ones? They're different sort of radishes.
They're baby turnips.
Turnips.
They taste a bit like a radish, but texture like an apple.
Oh, yum.
Yeah. Chuck that in, Sarah.
That's my favourite.
Nice.
That I could eat that.
A bit of that.
Don't eat much, Dave, really.
Bit of that.
Wow. Oh.
Yum.
That's really, really good.
Sarah, do you want to cut that straight down?
No wonder Mr. Lucas loved this.
I know, right?
Oh, it's beautiful.
Wow.
It's a work of art. That's what it is.
Not exactly. I was going to keep the top, but anyway.
I'll do it again. I'll try it again.
You haven't told us
just
what's
keep that beautiful leaf. This is Thousand Island dressing. It's just like...
Mayo.
Mm-hmm.
Lemon juice.
That's right. Worcestershire sauce, Tabasco, all that kind of stuff. A little bit of extra chilli.
Yum.
Look at that crab.
Oh, look. This looks like...
Oh, it's Easter coming.
Have a look at this.
Jar Jar
Binks. Jar Jar Binks. No, not
that looks fantastic. That.
Okay, great.
Like that.
How fantastic.
Oh,
that.
Love it. That's beautiful.
Some dill here. And a bit more dressing, and I reckon that's about it.
How brilliant.
That is fantastic.
We're going to taste this, but to check out some more incredible dishes, you can pop into Mr. G's Bar and Grill. Dave, you're wonderful. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.